Have you ever been so far below? You could only see light using a telescope. Pointed up to the sky and wonder why there's hope. Feel so far but look so close. Will you wander with me to the edge? Take a breath, tell the world that we're not finished yet. Cast a net to the stars and see if we can get closer to the light at the end. Let our eyes show the fire in our hearts
tonight. Out there, Lombard staff and students. It is Thankful Thursday. And as the principal of the school, my job is to kind of observe and see, hey, where are we doing things really well? And we try really hard here to celebrate those good things. But I also have to stop and try to focus on areas that we need to improve. And I've noticed, again, a lot of our students struggling with responses. And I guess I want to say a lot of our students have a lot of emotions, and we have emotional responses happening. And my greatest concern is that those emotional responses can not only affect ourselves individually, but it can hurt others, and it can really be something that you later on regret. And I'm also seeing that. So a lot of positive, growing type conversations happening in the office, but I thought it'd be a great way to kick off our announcements, because I know we have some staff that are very trained in this and also very knowledgeable, but I think it's important for our students to have a little lesson about our brain and something called flipping your lid. Have you heard of that before? Let's take a look at a very brief video, and staff, I will send you another video in case your students are very interested in it. Just a longer video for you to share. But let's watch this quick intro about flipping your lid.
The more you understand how your brain works and how thoughts and emotions interact, the more control you can have over your thoughts and emotions. It's your brain. It's time for you to start controlling your own thoughts and emotions. So let's talk about how thoughts and feelings interact. We're going to break it down using a visual, the hand model.
We're going to use our hand for this. Your thumb, folding it in, is the middle of your brain, your amygdala. Your fingertips, folding it around, is your prefrontal cortex, the front of your brain. We'll come back to this in a second.
Our amygdala is really important in serious situations. For example, if you see a fire, it alerts you into action. It cuts off access to your prefrontal cortex, where you think and reason, which is great. You don't need to calculate just how long it will take for the house to burn down. You just need to move.
Back to your hand. Your amygdala in the center, with the fingers curled around, flips the prefrontal cortex lid. Flip the lid. Try it with me. Put your thumb in the middle, hold your fingertips, and force your fingertips over with your thumb, the amygdala. This could save your life in the fire situation.
So we need our amygdala, but here's the problem. Your amygdala makes mountains out of molehills. So when there isn't a fire, and just say a pop quiz, your amygdala may react the same and flip your lid when there's no need to. When your lid is flipped, that's when your thoughts and emotions become muddled. When this happens, it means your thoughts are driven by your amygdala and they are often distorted. This can fuel your worry or anxiety.
So your lid is still flipped and you need your prefrontal cortex to perform well on that pop quiz. So you have to find a way to get the prefrontal cortex to come down so you can think and reason.
Bringing your lid down is tough for all of us. We'll dive further into that next.
Well, I hope some of you enjoyed that. I hope you have some additional questions. I hope you're also kind of thinking about yourself, especially when you're experiencing emotions. Because remember, having emotions is the normal thing to do as a human being. We all have that. And so we have to understand and learn to identify those emotions we're experiencing, whether it be anger, frustration, excitement, sadness, happiness. Those are all normal emotions. But it's when we try to respond with those emotions that sometimes we can affect ourselves and others. And that's why the flipping the lid is an important model for us to understand. Having a three-year-old at home, you all know what a toddler temper tantrum can look like. So even in my home, I try to model some different things to help my daughter Aaliyah when she's having those moments. One of the strategies that I just learned the other day, it just talks about trying to release that tension, because some of you I see, you know, your fists start clenching. You can even recognize maybe some different experiences that are different situations that you are, you start to just get tense. And so it just talks about actually pressing your palms together for 20 seconds. And then you release for 10 seconds. And then you do it again 3 to 4 times. And it's just a way for you to stop and think, release some pressure. All of it, it's amazing what our bodies and brains are doing. And then it will allow you to hopefully have a much calmer and more respectful response. So I wanted to share that because I recognize as a principal some of the areas that we are struggling with. And I wanna make sure our students know there are always strategies and other things that we can do to help you be successful. So I hope some of you enjoy that today. I think we can all apply that to our own lives and to our own experiences. Today, I will be coming around for those that like to be on our social media page or that like to be videotaped, but I'm looking for just some positive quotes, inspirational messages. So an example today for me would be to never give up. And I think that is so important in today's world. So that would be my positive message. So I want all of you to think about that. And if you see me in the hallway and you're interested in sharing one of those for our social media page, please make sure you connect with me so I can make sure others hear the inspiring words and messages from our Lombard Zephyrs.
Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't mean today, you know what we mean, eh? Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't mean today, you know what we mean, eh? Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday.
And we hope you have a wonderful birthday. And now let's hear what's on the lunch menu for today.
It's time to get some
lunch, lunch. It's time for lunch, lunch. It's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch. It's time for lunch, not brunch.
On the brunch menu for today, it's French toast sticks, hash browns, fruit cocktail, vegetable juice with a mango taste, and your choice of white or chocolate milk. That is it for morning announcements today. I know my opening was a little longer, so we're going to end it here because we've got to get ready for tomorrow, which is our celebration day. So I'd like to end again on a positive. As always, Zephyrs, go be great.
Today is a new day, a day I promise to work hard, be kind, show pride, and celebrate who I am.